What's up, everybody? This is Mike Wall, team leader of the Love Ohio Living Team at eXp Realty, joined by one of my real estate partners, Miss Melissa Rhodes. Melissa, how are you today?
I'm super.
Good, 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 good. Well, I am really excited to have you on in particular because you are having such great success. And when I say success, you are absolutely crushing it. You are, I would say, you've been with us for about 90 days, maybe a little over, because the way you started, you went on vacation to Florida right away, and you know, obviously we ran into Christmas. So in reality, you started January 1, and you and I were talking a little bit before we started the video, is that the reason why we're doing these videos is we want to provide some educational content for agents to be able to land on so that they can make decisions that will enable them to build a thriving business that is sustainable, right? And continue to provide the lifestyle or a better lifestyle than what they had before. Because let's face it, I mean, people get into real estate for one reason, and that's to make money. But they want to get into real estate to make money to provide a better lifestyle, either for themselves or their families. Would you agree with that?
I agree.
Yep. And so for you, I just think it would be so impactful for you to kind of share your story, because you and I found each other, and basically it was just dumb luck. I got an email from eXp's mentoring department, and it had your information on it, and I accepted it. And you know, you came in, met me here at the office, and we just started talking, and we really kind of hit it off. But you know, you've seen kind of both ends of this business, and the title of the video is going to be, you know, should new real estate agents consider joining a team? So you saw a little bit of the other side of what it's like to be on your own, and now you've seen what it's like to be in a team environment. So let's rewind a little bit, kind of to when you got into this industry. First of all, I want to know why you got in this industry. In other words, what was it that prompted you to say, hey, I want to get my real estate license? And then talk about kind of when you started, and then we'll kind of transition into what it's meant to you to be on our team. So go ahead and get started.
Okay. Well, I got into the industry actually out of a really weird way. When everything shut down last year, I was an event coordinator for a concert venue in Franklin, and the owner of that venue got his real estate license. Another thing I did was just pretty much anything he couldn't get to, I handled. So as soon as he did that, I said, well, I guess I need a license then if you want me to handle anything to do with that.
Sure.
So I jumped in. I think it was supposed to be 12 weeks to get it, and I did it in six and got my license. And he had taken a different path where he used his license for flipping houses. He started the Flipping Dayton.
Right.
And I was completely clueless in regards to how and what. So I just kind of sat there waiting, like, okay, well, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
And eXp was great with giving me a nice list of things, you know, go through this list, check this off. I'm like, that's great. Now what?
Yeah.
So I saw something pop through my email about a mentorship program. And that's when I said, oh, maybe that's what I need. Mm-hmm. So I signed up for that. And that's how I met you.
Yeah,
I totally came into your office.
Give a little background on kind of your personality. I mean, you're a very ambitious and driven type person, and it was driving you literally nuts.
It was
to not know what to do, right?
I was like, I had this like anxiety, this irritable anxiety by the time I came to you, because I just spent this money, just spent this time. I did all my classes in the middle of the night because didn't want to take away from time with my family. Prior to the event coordinator for the concert venue, my husband and I started an entertainment company in 2005, in which we developed a brand new way of DJing a couple times.
Yeah.
And we still do it here and there. But I'm used to working for myself.
Yeah.
I'm used to having to drive the train. But when it came to this, I was completely lost. I didn't know what to do. I literally thought real estate agents just showed houses. I was like, why do they get paid so much to just show a house?
Yeah.
So I did all the classes. I joined that mentorship program because I didn't know what to do. And I was like, I have all this knowledge. I'm going to forget it because I'm not applying it. Somebody let me in their office. Let me see what's going on. Please let me use it because I'll lose it.
Yeah.
And I can't just, I get so stir crazy and everything was shut down. There was no concerts. So I joined that mentorship program because I was about to explode. That's what it felt like. And within probably 3 minutes of talking to you, it went from me looking at you as like a mentor to, oh, well, how does your team work? I remember asking you that and feeling really inquisitive. I'm like, so how does that work? What is that structure? And you mentioned a contract manager, and that's all the legal stuff. That's all the stuff. I mean, like I said, I went through those classes pretty fast and in the middle of the night.
Yep.
So I'm like, I can always go back and reference stuff, but you said there's a contract manager.
Well, I mean, let's face it, really good salespeople are not good at administrative work, and really good admins are not good at sales, right? They're two different types of people. And that's why we have a good admin team in place, is to be able to support great salespeople like yourself.
She was so helpful. Within just, like you said, I did kind of start in December. We had Thanksgiving right after I met you. And then the first 2 weeks of December, I was in Florida. Yep. And then I came back the week before Christmas. And you got me set up with our lead generation system, a couple of them. And showed me how to, like, I was horrified to make cold calls. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. I was terrified to call people. And you gave me a whole new perspective. I'm not cold calling these people.
Yeah.
I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. I'm serving them. I'm helping them because they obviously are looking for a house and they put their information to get a follow-up. So it changed my whole world right there. It's like, oh, I'm literally just following up like I should, because I love to help people.
Yep.
And so the calls after realizing that, the calls were super easy. I think I've gotten into my groove on what I say when I have time to make them. And then I got a lead through one of the generations. It was an app. And I got that. I called, I went and showed houses on Christmas Eve in the snow.
Yeah. I remember that.
And they wanted to put a contract down, and I had never written a contract.
Yeah.
I didn't know what to do. And I remember we have a wonderful contract manager, and I called her up. She helped me, another agent in the office. I got to give a shout out to my boy, John Clark, Christmas Eve on the phone with me while I'm in the church parking lot. I've got John and Tangi, and I got Revolution. Got to give some love to John over there, who also helped to walk me through everything all together. Never in my life, I would not have been able to do that without them. And it was Christmas Eve. So not only were these people there to help me, but they helped me on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
And then they helped me with my second one on New Year's Eve.
I love it, man. And so a couple things I want to touch on here really quickly that I don't want to gloss over, because these are two of the most critical components, not just for new agents, but for any agent for that matter, is the fact that we do have lead generation in place. And many of the teams that you'll consider joining, they already have that lead generation in place. And the reason why that's important is because there's a significant amount of money that's invested in that. A lot of new agents, and some seasoned agents for that matter, they don't have the type of money that it takes to be able to invest in that up front, because it could be several thousand dollars. And so often that's another reason why new agents and some seasoned agents will join a team, because they want that lead generation in place. And it is critical to have that, because without leads, you don't have a business. And then the second part of that that's really important that Melissa touched on is the fact that you get the support of an entire team, right? Not only do you get the support of your admin, your contract manager, your listing manager, you also get the support of your team members, which is, which is invaluable. And, she's talking about writing offers on Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve and getting the support from her administrative staff, her agent staff, and her ancillary partner staff at the mortgage company. And these are just, these are just two of the really critical components that new agents really need to consider when getting into our industry, because without them, it's going to be that much harder to be able to succeed. Would you agree with that, Mel?
Absolutely. Yeah. I went from being stuck and not going anywhere to like somebody lit a match.
Yeah.
It's been such a blessing. Another touch on the team part of it and being able to rely on them. Last month, my husband and I went to Vegas for the first time to renew our wedding vows. I set up some alerts for my clients, saw a house come through that they liked, and I sent an email out to everybody on the team and said, hey, can someone go show this house? Those clients are now first-time homeowners, thanks to my team member getting out there and showing the houses to them. Yeah. While I was in Vegas, I wrote the offer there and everything. I was able to call my contract manager and get it all taken care of. And again, it was because I had that infrastructure in place that I could call and rely on them. That's invaluable to me.
I remember your post on Facebook. I think you were on the balcony overlooking the strip at your hotel with your laptop in your lap, and you took a picture. And you had a contract up, you were writing it out. I don't remember what the post said, but I just remember that picture because it so resonated with me. And, you know, again, that's one of the benefits of being on a team is you've always got that internal help, right? It's everybody rowing the same direction, and it's everybody helping everybody else out. And it's really critical, especially when you're in a more challenging market like we're in right now, where there just aren't a whole heck of a lot of listings, and listings are selling within hours, sometimes within minutes, right?
Yeah.
And so we have to have that type of help. And we want to be able to go on vacations with our family if we want to. We want to know we have that support on the back end so that our business is still going to move forward. You know, I always think about, like, with new agents, you know, they don't, what they don't teach you in real estate, well, the only thing they do teach you really is to pass an exam, right? That's what they're doing. You're going to school and they're teaching you how to pass an exam, right? And so once you pass that exam, then what, right? What they don't teach you is how to build a successful, sustainable business that will not just get by, but will thrive. And so you have to figure that out really quickly on your own. There is no class for that. And so one of the big benefits of joining a team is you're usually able to join a team who's maybe doing, you know, a couple hundred transactions a year. And as a byproduct of that, you can learn really quickly or shorten the learning curve extensively to get where you want to go. So, you know, oftentimes joining a team is a really good stepping stone for success, or you may choose to stay because you may just enjoy the benefits that a team has to offer. But with Melissa, you know, obviously she's done really well. I think she had three deals under contract in like 45 days, which was just amazing. And, you know, she'll probably go on to sell 24, 25 homes this year, which is, for a first-year agent, by the way, it's incredible. And not only that, but she's really kind of living a lifestyle that is conducive to now having more balance, spending time with her family, because, you know, I don't know if you remember this, Mel, and this is kind of the last thing I'll touch on, but we've met a couple different times because when you first started, like, you ramped up really quickly, but you got so busy, you had to sacrifice time with your family. And we know, listen, that's not what we're looking to do here. We want success, but we want success in business. We want success in health. We want success with our family, right? And if we don't have if we don't have balance in all aspects of our life, then that's not success, right? And so when you and I met, we needed to recast a vision for your business, didn't we? And so talk about that a little bit.
Okay. Yeah. When we first started, I mean, you gave me my goals and I really didn't even know how to set goals in an industry I've never dealt with. And my comfort zone is all in. My comfort zone is diving in head first. And I have a tendency to let it consume me and let the business run me instead of the other way around. And thanks to having a team and having your mentorship, but those around me, my teammates, I've been able to finagle a way to have a successful business and keep moving forward without sacrificing that time with my family. I'm finding a nice rhythm here, and it's with the guidance of you guys. I feel like for the first time in my life, I found the shortcut somewhere.
There you go.
I'm torn between whether I just stay here or whether I end up being like the great Mike Wall, but.
And either way, thing about EXP, right? Is, you know, the opportunity for revenue share. And it is just it's an environment that's conducive to helping each other succeed. And that's, you know, that's really important.
Yeah. There's so many ways that you can make money with this instead of just buying and selling homes with the revenue share, like you're talking about. And then if I inspire someone else to become an agent and they join, I can make money through that passively, which is kind of got that multi, I love the many faceted ways of producing income with this company, and being part of a team is the only way I really could have started.
Yeah,
I didn't know what to do until I came in there. The lead generation, it's hard to talk about something you're not doing.
Yeah.
So people say, well, I know a lot of people. Trust me, I know a lot of people. Yeah. But it's hard to go to and say, hey, I'm an agent now, when I'm not really doing it yet. And when I started doing the lead generation with you and getting clients that way, I naturally was talking about what I was doing and where I went and saw houses and the cats that jumped out, you know, and that inspired people to listen to me. So now I'm like, the lead generation is sitting right here, but I've got all this coming from just the fact that I finally got involved, and it's thanks to being part of a team for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, and just so you know, I am equally as happy to have been able to meet you and be able to provide a platform for you to come in and have the success that you've had. That's what it's all about in my mind's eye. I like, we are looking for agents who are truly looking to build a sustainable real estate business. They're not just in it for a hobby. These are people that are looking to build a six-figure and beyond business. And although rare, we do find them every now and then, like we did with Miss Melissa. And we are always looking, right? And we're looking for people who are hungry, humble, and smart. And these are people who can plug into our system. And no matter if they're new or if they've been in the business for 10 years, they're going to have success because we have a blueprint for that. And so I invite you, if you are investigating brokerages, whether you're new or you've been in the business for 10 plus years, reach out to myself, and you can always schedule time on my calendar at www.meetmikewall.com. Mel, any parting shots for the audience?
Just do it. You got to do something.
There you go. Listen, don't get any easier than that right there. Just do it, right?
Hopefully, just do it.
Hopefully we're not violating any copyright laws for Nike, right? Just do it.
Well, I added the got to do something. That's got to count, right?
Yep.
I think I've been using the failing forward part a lot. It's okay, because with a team, you have a nice safety net.
Absolutely. It's nice. Well, Mel, thank you so much for taking some time out of your busy day. I look forward to seeing you absolutely destroy it this year. And thanks so much for offering your insight to our audience.
Well, thank you for having me on here. It's an honor.
Thanks, Mel.